Today's topic we'll discuss about something called as Hadoop. So heard about Hadoop, Kavi? Heard about Hadoop? No one? Okay. Let's go in this way. Let's start with the topic something called as IT, then move towards computer, then we'll move towards data, then we'll move towards big data, and then we'll move towards Hadoop. Okay, this all are in sync. So, when you talk about IT, what is IT means? It's about information, right? So we have information and technology, right? So sensibly, when you think about it, so normally people think it's as getting information about technology. It's actually reverse, right? It is about using technology to work with information. That means our main motto as IT professional is to work with information. So we have to use some technology, or we have to build some technology to work with those information, right? So initially everything was on books. So you had this technology where you can write data on books. Now think about business now. Business started way long, right? Example, if you talk about 19th century, there was also business, maybe with barter system. Before that, there was system where you can share rocks. They used to use gold coins in India, right? And then long back, let's say you have a generation when we didn't have papers. Just think about it. Now you share information on paper, right? Or maybe 100 years back, you used to share information on papers. Let's say I want to ask you something. So I have to write something and then I will give it to you. And then you will reply on the same paper or a different paper, right? Now, way back, maybe 2000 years back, at that time, no papers, no computer, obviously. So that time, they used to share information on rocks. Let's say I'm a human and after 20 years, I got some knowledge. I want to share that knowledge with my generation, with my future generation, let's say my kids, their kids, how to share that information. So I will take a rock, I will use some other rock, and I will write some information on that. So knowledge I have, I will share it on rocks. And then there was invention, which is paper. So instead of writing on rocks, now you can write on papers. And then we have new generation or new technology where you can share information using computers. Yeah. Now think about IT professionals. What our main task is to work with information. That means start to end, we work with information, right? So if we talk about Google, they work with information. If we talk about Facebook, they work with information. So all different company, their main motto is to work with information, right? Okay. Now let's go in this way. Let's say you are working for a company like Infosys. Is it your dream?
No.
I'm so happy, Infosys. Okay, so let's say you're working for Infosys. What will be your main task? There will be lots of departments. So one of the department will be a programming department or software development department. Then there will be a department called a testing department. And then there will be a department like maintenance department. And then a weird type of department is tech support. Okay, now let's say you're doing BSc IT or BCA or MCA. What we learn programming, we learn testing, we learn about how to take requirements. I hope you have a subject called as software engineering, in that you have those seven phases. In fact, some people have a different subject called as SRS. It's a topic of research, SRS. How about this SRS? It stands for?
Software
specification, right? So we have to use SRS to work with those requirements, right? Now, so you have different phases. You have different department like development department. Then we have testing department, and then we have maintenance department. In that we have tech support, right? So if you are good at development, you will go for development. If you are good at testing, you will go for testing. Again, we have two types there. We have a black box testing and we have white box testing, right? So depend upon your qualification, your skill set, they will put you in somewhere. Then there's a department called tech support. There you have to support the product which are made by developers. So let's say you are making a banking application. So who will create that application? Developers. Who will test it? Testers. And who will give support? Then we have a team called a tech support. they will provide the support. Right? Now, so your main task is to create those software which will work with information. So when you build a software, why you build a software? For information. Right? Why we test? So that software will work with a good or right information. That's why we test. And why we support? Let's say your software is not working. What will not work? Your data. Think about banking transactions. You know, there were days when you used to work with money or currency, physical money. And now we work with e-money or e-currency, online transactions. Where is the money? No rupees, no dollars. It's all about count. Right? You heard about bitcoins, virtual coins. No physical money. It will be virtual money. Okay, just think about it. If you have a software which maintains all these bitcoins, and someday some hacker hacked that software, that's it, gone. All your bitcoins, gone. And that's why we require testing. So, why we require software to work with information? Why we require developers to build that software? Why we require tester to test that software? Why we require tech support to support that software? So, everything is about software and everything is about data. Right? Now, so as per our research, 90% of world data is created in last two years. Think about computers. From last 40 years we have computers, right? Or last 50 years we have computers. Right? And when you talk about computers, it generates data. So maybe in petabytes, maybe in zettabyte. Right? It generates data, right? So if you say there is X amount of data now, from that X amount of data from last 50 years, 90% of data is created in last 2 years. Just think about it. In last 2 years. That means world is changing. From data, we are moving towards data. Right? Now, where to save data? We can use, in programming we use variables, right? So let's say you want to store a number 5. What you will do? You will create a variable I. So you will say int I equal to 5. Simple. That means your I is a container where you can store your data. Right? But let's say you are creating a software. In that you have a variable I. That software will be in a RAM, or that variable in a RAM will be in a RAM till your software is open. Once you close that software, data gone. It's because anything which works on RAM is called as volatile memory or volatile applications. If your system goes down, your data goes vanish. Now just think about it. You have variables, so variables are volatile. Now let's say you want to store that information somewhere. Where you will store? You want to store that variable or that data in a permanent storage. So instead of storing it in RAM, you will store it in hard drive. Okay, let's go from base. Okay, it's not database, hard drive. So you store your data on hard drives. So what are hard drives? Secondary storage, you can say. Your RAM is also called as primary storage. So you should store your data in hard drives. Right? But every hard drive will have something called as file system. Right? So if you talk about Windows, Windows provide you file system which is called as NTFS. There is Windows file system, which is new technology file system. Then Windows also support FAT32 file system. And that FAT means, you heard about this, right? That FAT means? It is file allocation table. You heard about this, right? FAT32. When you connect your pen drive, when you try to format it, so we get, right, this FAT32 file system. So FAT means file allocation table, and the bits version we use is 32 bits. That's why it is FAT32. Then we have something called as ext4. This extension is used by Linux. Then we have something called as ext3. This is used by, again, Linux. So this is old version of Linux file system. This is new version of Linux file system. Anyone who have used Linux here? 1, 2, 3. What about you? Windows. Okay. So if you talk about Windows, Windows uses NTFS and FAT32. If you talk about Linux, Linux uses ext4 and ext3. Clear? That means to store data, you need a file system. Now, what exactly file system means? Let's say you want to build a building. So that building structure, in that building, you'll be having lots of floors. Every floor will have lots of gala or rooms. So that room structure means file system. Structuring your hard drive or creating a block in your hard drive is called as file system. Clear? It's dimensions, its size, and the way it will be saved. That defines file system. Clear? Okay. So, example, if you talk about Windows file system, it has different file system. Windows has different file system, Linux has different file system. Linux supports Windows file system, but Windows doesn't support Linux file system. Example, if you have a pen drive which works with 532, you can use this pen drive in Windows also, you can use this pen drive in Linux also. Because Linux knows about both the file system. But if you format a pen drive using ext4, then you can only use that pen drive in Linux, not in Windows. Because Windows doesn't support ext4 file system. And that's why all your pen drive, by default, they have FAT32 file system. Clear? Alright. Now if you talk about file system, where to store values? You cannot take a value and put it on file system. You have to take some container. And that container basically is called as file. So you need to take a file where you can store your data. And that's why in C programming you have file handling. In Java also you have file handling. In all different languages you have file handling. It's because you can develop a software and from that software you can store those values in files. So instead of storing data in variables, you can store it in files. Clear? Example, when you open Notepad, you create TXT files. You create DOC file in Windows, this MS Word. You create Excel file. So all those files are called as normal files. So TXT is also file, right? Then DOC is also file. XLS is also file. So everything is file. So from your software, you can store that data in a file. And this file will be stored in file system. Clear? So your software will generate some data and you will store that data in this file. And this file will be stored on file system. Now depend upon if you are using Windows, you will store in NTFS. If you are using Linux, you will store this file in ext4 file system. Clear? Is it comfortable to work with files? Where do you store your data? Let's say you want to build a software. Where do you store your data? In files? And then there is a person called as CORD. What about CORD? CORD 12 rules. First year, it's okay. First year, it's okay. What about you? You have SQL, no? So, who is CORD? The man behind something called as RDB. Now, what is RDB? RDB stands for Relational Database, which means it will be a base where you can store all your data in a format, and that format will be table format. Right? The advantage is, let's say you want to store three values, roll number, name, and marks. Where you will store? In file. So let's go with file, txt file. So let's say you have file here. In this file you have roll number 1, then you have name like Ali, and what's up? 80 marks? Will do? Roll number 2, let's go with Dipesh, and maybe 82? Will do? This one I will see. Roll number 3, let's say we have Archu, and marks is 75. A great college, right? So let's say you have this marks. So let's say I want to know marks of roll number 2 in Notepad. How will you search? You have to take your finger and you have to go down in Notepad. I want to know the marks of roll number 2. So So you take your finger, you have to roll down to your this roll number, and then at roll number 2, you have to go to the last field, which is 82, right? Or you, let's say you have a file of 1000 records, what you will do now? Search. So you will say control F, you will type 2, enter, and then it will highlight that 2, right? And then you will use your finger again and then say okay, 82. Simple. Let's say you're working with something called as RDB. RDB works with a software called as, which software we use for RDB? Type of software called as RDBMS. And the example of RDBMS? MySQL, then we have Oracle, then we have PLS, SQL Server, then we have PostgreSQL. So all these softwares are RDBMS. And this software supports something called as SQL. Right? So using SQL, you can fire queries. Now one of the, do you know SQL? First year students? No, right? It's okay. On SQL, basically, you can use some queries to fetch data. Now, what type of query we write here? I want to know the marks of roll number 2. So, what will be the query?
Select star from table name.
So, it is select star. I don't want all the values. I just want marks. So, select marks from table. Let's say it is list. Then, where roll number is equal to 2. If I execute this query, what I will get is only 82. I don't have to use my finger this time. Clear? And that's the advantage of using SQL instead of using Control F on Notepad. That's the advantage of using RDB than using TXT files. So world have moved from files to RDB. And problem starts here. From last 2 years, the world data, 90% of data is generated in last 2 years. Now think about this. Let's say we have 20 years back, 1995 or 1990s maybe. At that time, when you say data is generated, by whom? Those people who use computers. Or those employees of the company who generate data, like account report, or balance sheet, or manufacturing report, or sales report. So that's how we create data. Then we had a world of where we had a Gmail or Yahoo Mail in year 2000. Who create data? Who has created data? It's normal people or retailers. Like when you go to shopping, not in India, I'm talking about US people. They had this system of software and computers way back. In India we have now, right? From last 3 to 4 years. They had from last 15 years. So there, they used to create data using retailers or maybe online bill payment. Then we had a year of 2005. Data was generated by users. Facebook. Then we have Google, YouTube. Then we have Orkut, yeah. So we use all this website to generate data. So earlier it was employees, then it was normal shopkeepers, and then it is users. And now, you know, you have some sensors on buildings, climate sensors, then we have temperature sensors, wind sensors, and then we have, you heard about this one called as IoT? Okay, we'll talk about this. So we have all these sensors, right? So data is now generated by employees, shopkeepers, users, and most important, devices. Robots create data. How much data? As per Cisco, by the end of 2015, in 1 year, you'll be getting 4.8 zettabytes per year. This much of internet traffic, only internet traffic will be generated. You know how much is zettabyte? Any guess? 1 zettabyte is equal to It is 1 billion. Any guess? 1 billion terabytes. Just imagine 4.8 zettabyte of data will be generated in 1 year. And all this data will go into a system called as RDB. Okay, so users are, or who create data now? Employees, shopkeepers, users, and softwares. Now the world is moving towards something called as IoT. Now IoT stands for, it is Internet of Things. How many of you know about this, IoT? Achha, you heard about Google car, self-driving cars. What do you think, how it will work? Obviously you have to use internet. Obviously they will use GPS. That means that car has a sensor, a GPS sensor, and lots of sensors to handle it. And that car is in continuous supported with your internet service. What if you're driving a car and internet gone? Then you are gone. Right? But Google will make sure internet will be there. At least for that car. Okay? That means that car has a sensor and that sensor will generate data. Right? Then we have ACs. You can control your AC with remote, with your mobile phone. In future, now also you can control your AC with your mobile phone, again with packet data. That means if you are outside, still you can handle your AC. You can check your fridge contents with your mobile phone, provided your fridge has a sensor. That means every device in future will be having internet service. And all this device will generate some data. And that some data will be data. We have 7 billion people on earth. And every person has 2 to 3 phones now. Every person will have a TV. Or at least one home will have one TV. That TV will also have a sensor. That means all these devices, that more than 10 billion devices will generate data. And that data will not be a data, it will be a data. And that's why to handle this data, we cannot use data word. And that's why we have to use a new word called as big data. Clear? Now for companies, data is very important. Obviously, company works with data, right? Now let's say you have a company, and in month of April, they have this cycle, year cycle. And before that, they take some decisions. That next year we have to implement this plan, or we will go for this thing. They take decisions based on what? Based on reports. What is report? Data. That means the effectiveness of your decision will be depend upon the effectiveness of your reports. The effectiveness of your report is depend upon the amount of data. Right? It's both quality of data and the quantity of data. So what this company is doing is, they are using more and more data. Example, if you talk about Amazon, they want to get as much as detail about their customers. Facebook, they want you to update your status. They want you to update your phone number. More data, more customers. Google, why Google has maximum money now? Because they own your data. Every company need data. So earlier, maybe 15 years back, let's say I'm a company, maybe Mercedes. Any company name? Huh? Levin company. That's weird. Give me a company name. Let's go with Camlin. So let's say I'm the owner of Camlin. Okay? So if I want to manage my data, so what I will do? I will go to some company who are expert in managing data. Let's say Oracle. So I will go to Oracle and say, this is my data. You have to manage this. So all the processing, all the storing, that you have to do. What's my job? To generate data. What's your job? To work with that data.